Papyrus Kali was techniques employed to improve pronunciation in the English classroom. This object of study emerged in a third grade scene from Colegio Santo Tomás de Unión, located in Santiago, Chile. How did this popular study emerge? Was because through observation records, I could appreciate that the teacher put a great emphasis on what it was for techniques to improve the pronunciation. I could see that she made readings together aloud and different kind of techniques. According to this, I could appreciate those and what it seems to be so important for them. And when I asked the teacher, she told me that the school itself tell the teachers to put a great emphasis on what was two English features, that was pronunciation and fluency. So the techniques that she used was according to those two features. Through these observation records, it was possible to look for this research question that was, is there a relationship between the confidence to speak English in students of third grade from primary education and the corrections or praises regarding pronunciation given by the teacher? Through the observation records, as I said, I could notice that some students felt more confident when the teacher praised their way of speaking English in terms of pronunciation. On the contrary, some other students felt more their participation decreased after the teacher corrected their pronunciation. I think that it's very important to include what pronunciation is. I took this definition from the AMET Research Center that says that pronunciation refers to the production of sounds that we use to make meaning. It includes attention to the particular sounds of a language, aspects of speech beyond the level of the individual sound, such as intonation, phrasing, stress, timing, and rhythm. The selection of basic lecture materials. Why I selected this material that was a questionnaire was because it was a quantitative research. We could see that the quantitative research is used to different sciences such as physics, biology, psychology. Since what I'm looking forward in this research is confidence, I think that it's better related to psychology. That's why I choose a quantitative research. In addition, the purpose of this was to quantify the results. So that was another reason why I used a quantitative research. The questionnaire, as you can see, there is classroom observation. These are some of the elements that it can be included in a questionnaire. This questionnaire included 8 questions that were closed questions, and it has to do with classroom observation itself. The assessment of trustworthiness. Well, to start with, the first step of this process of validation was to contact 3 validators that had an expertise on the matter. To them, it was sent a questionnaire that included the 8 questions, and you can see the level of acceptability that each one gave to the answers. The question 3 was the only one that had a low average, so it was the only one that needed to be changed. The other ones included were more than the 17%, so it didn't need a change. This result was through a Likert scale that, as we know, is a type of attitude scale which corresponds to a level of ordinal measurement made up by a series of actions or judgments to which a reaction of the student's subject is requested. The stimulus presented to the subject is the property that the researcher is interested in measuring, and responses are requested in terms of degree of agreement or disagreement. This was taken from Padua, page 160. So, the conclusion, this question demonstrated was that 84% of the students feel confident after the teachers gave them praises to speak English. And only 8% of the students No, neither agree or disagree in terms of that they think that it didn't matter really. They say that it didn't affect it. And 8% of the students didn't answer this question. The other important question is that some of the students, on the contrary of what I thought, only 58% still have desire to speak English after the corrections made by the teacher. Only 25% neither agree or disagree, and 17% did not answer this question. This question was applied only to a demonstrative sample of the grade. It wasn't applied to the whole class. Okay. Now let's go to the metacognitive analysis. The learning objective that my way to explain was expresarse oralmente, ya sean diálogos, presentaciones o actividades grupales, con apoyo del lenguaje visual y digital en torno a los temas del año. This was taken from Mineduc of 2013. The content was really wide. It was one regarding my work. Some of the contents that they had to do is describing their family, describing places of the school, and describing objects of the school. Some of that strength that I can, in this hypothetical situation, I thought about being in a grade in which, as one of the topics is to describing family, I noticed that some of the students doesn't live with their parents or have different family situations. For this, I think that empathy would be one of my strengths, because I can try to transmit that to the students, teach them through respect and how to be empathy with the other. In terms of my weaknesses, I think that it would be self-regulation of emotions. And you can see here we have the definition of emotions. Actually this wasn't hypothetical at all, because in my last practicum, I have this situation in which I didn't know how to react in front of this situation in which we have to talk about family. And one of my students told me, I don't have a dad, he's dead. And I was really shocked, and I really didn't know what could I say. And I was in silence like for a couple of seconds, but for me it felt like minutes. And I really, really didn't know what to do. And I was staring at my classmates, they stared at me like, what are we going to do now? So I think that one of my weaknesses is regulate my emotions in order to know how to act in front of every kind of situation. The challenges in this case would be autonomy in terms of making decisions. This wasn't that hypothetical at all, also because at my practical I had the situation in which the teacher missed several classes because it was without medical leave, but they didn't notify this to me, so I didn't know if I should continue the class, if I should review, what should I do in that case. And I put in this hypothetical situation, but if I'm a substitute teacher and I have to do this because the teacher plan isn't there, should I continue teaching, should I advance, should I move forward, what should I do? And another challenge that I found is related with the silent period of crashes in the hypothesis, because I'm trying to look here for the oral expressions of the students. So what if they don't know, if they're in this period? Maybe they don't want to talk, they don't feel confident, and what can I do in this case? What should I do? Should I allow them to keep continuing that period? Should I try to look for other strategies? So I think that it would be a challenge, as I said, because you never know what can you expect from a situation like that. So here are the references that I took.
Now we'll start with questions.